Okay, so I finished up Russian Poppet's slicker brush. Pin brush side, and then I slicker brushed it. And now I'm going to do the finishing on the other side and show you what I'm doing with some of the roughen stuff. So here we go. So now I want to tell you why we brush this away from the body, up and away. And that's because we want to get the hair moving up away from the dog so that we can get underneath the hair follicles. When we do, so now the hair grows on this part of her body, grows towards her butt. It's going to lay flat that way. So if I get the hair detangled and all the debris moved, while the hair is being pushed upward, it's going to give me a fluffier dog. It's going to allow more air to pass through the coat, which is important if you're working on summer brushings to help the dog keep cool. You're going to want to do that. Okay, so I'm using, again, I'm still line brushing. I'm using my slicker brush to help make those little lines. Parts. Now here, look at me come up towards her neck. I'm able to get into here because she's keeping her head down. That's part of actually the behavior that I teach, the bang skill. You gotta have your head down. So I'm able to get into some of the thicker parts of her without having to cause her any discomfort. And I'm gonna work all the way back to her butt, almost her tail. We're drying a little bit, so I'm not afraid to add a little bit more water. And again, I'm going to come along and I'm going to move the next line of hairs out of the way, making a new part. And I'm going to continue. Look at how much hair I'm getting. So this process is actually really good for helping remove a lot of the excess shedding that's happening. And I'm seeing some debris in my dog's coat. Little Miss likes to go out and lay in the gravel and stuff. Her favorite big rock. Keep eye on the deer. Whoops. Ooh, are we okay? Let's check. I think we're okay. And back to line brushing. I'm moving my brush down the line. But, you know, this is a house dog who does go out and enjoy being wild. Okay, making my next part. Moving my way along. I'm going to move the hair again up towards her back. So you see how this brush, the tool, bang please, good girl, sweetheart, is separating the hair better than the pin brush did. The pin brush got all the hair started so it would be more comfortable for my dog. Removed the large debris, dealt with a bit of the tangles if I had any good sized tangles, and oh bang, you had a girl. And now I'm using this tool to further separate the hair, further get towards the skin, and I do find tangles on my dog. She's been needing to be brushed for over a week. This is a fairly coaty dog. Look at all her coat. I might even work a little bit of the de-shedding tool on her. Oh, you're such a good girl, sweetheart. I love this dog. This is my favoriteest dog. So look at how much hair that I'm getting off. Bang. Thank you. Just on that little bit that I did. So, again, finding a new part, half inch or so lower. So she's being really patient and good, isn't she? Oh my good little Poppet. Yes, I'm such a good girl. I'll give her a little head pat because she's deaf. Not totally deaf, but definitely is having less hearing as she's aging. And frankly, if I've got to pick a senior thing to deal with, being deaf's okay. I'm glad I taught her hand signals and stuff as a youngin', because we use them every day now. Come and wait and sit. I don't ask her to do a lot of stuff, but sit's something I'm glad I've got. Sorry, I was just back, working back on that leg a little bit. Oh, yeah. Hi. I know, bang, good girl. So, have you noticed on our dogs there's some areas that are particularly tangleful? I have. So I'm just going to slide her away a little bit here. Are you okay there, sweetheart? I'm going to apply a bit more water because we're going to come along and deal with some of this. And this. Now, you can tell, I can tell, that I haven't been through some of that with the pin brush yet. So that's where I'm going to start. I know, it's a good little Pop-Tarts. Oh, it's a my good girl. Okay, so up, 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 down, 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 down. I want to make sure that my tool is always flat to the dog. Flat. I don't want to be digging in with the outer edge to the dog. So I make sure that flat to the dog. Hello, there's your little nipple. I know, girls have those, don't they? So now I'm going to work through her belly a bit. And look, don't let her lie. She likes this part. You see her little footy go? It went. I saw it. Faking like she's poor and hard done by. All right. So look how easy this is going to be to get in between her legs here. That's difficult when dogs are standing, and especially if you're doing this by yourself. I can do the back of the leg fairly easily. I can get around her girl parts. I'm going to get into this leg here. Yeah, my good little puppet. She doesn't seem to mind, but then no dog likes it when you're being pulley and ouchy. There we go. That looks much better. Okay, I'm going to come up here in between the armpits. So one of my tricks is I'm going to grab her elbow hair above her elbow, and then I'm going to slide it towards her wrists so I can pick up all that hair and get out of my way. So that's how I did that. Lifting, lifting, lifting. Now, I didn't do the other side, so let me just work through that a little bit. Again, how do we get this leg out of the way, sweetheart? I got the arm. Oh, people can't see, but they can't see. So now I'm going to comb the direction of her growth, which on her body is from her shoulders to her tail. So I'm just smoothing this out. You can see how nice and fluffy it is. So that if I wanted to do some more thinning, so this is always the last tool we use, it actually is going to find any tangles. If you've done a good job, your tool will slide. Oop, didn't do a very good job. There we go. Your tool will slide fairly nicely through the coat. And you can see, look at some hair I could have done better with my slicker brush. All right.